We have prepared a detailed step-by-step tutorial for you about the new layer system that came to Microsoft Paint after Windows 11. This is the fourth in a series of comprehensive and detailed tutorials for beginners and those who want to learn about the new Microsoft Paint post-Windows 11. To get the most out of this training, following this content and our previous and subsequent or other related trainings that we publish in series will help you understand and achieve much more. As soon as we open the program, we are greeted by a workspace with a white canvas in the middle and a new, Microsoft Paint, that blends classic and modern style. The canvas is the image space inside the workspace. You can think of it like a real-life canvas. This is where the image is created and organized. To explain the subject better, we write and scribble something on the canvas with a brush. When we paint the text we wrote with a brush with the second color white, it looks like it has been erased because the background color is white. In the past, since Paint had limited support for transparency and no layer system, painting with the background color, which was usually white, gave the same result as erasing. The new post-Windows 11 Microsoft Paint has radically transformed and transformed this entire editor with its transparency and layering systems, and now manages to incorporate a lot of open-ended potential. The most remarkable revolutionary new feature is, of course, the layer system. Layer systems are a must-have in many professional graphic design programs. When using the eraser tool, if the background is blank or no other layer is visible, a checkered pattern may appear behind the area you are erasing. This pattern is called a checkered ghost background and represents transparency in Paint. The eraser tool in Paint works in transparent mode by default. This shows the pixels behind the area you are erasing. The checkered pattern represents the background in Paint and shows what is behind the area you are erasing. We opened the layers section and it's clear that there is no other layer on the back, so when we deleted it, the checkered ghost background pattern appeared. If we use the selection tool to select and delete larger parts or even the entire layer we are on, the checkered ghost background pattern is completely revealed. We can assign the background color we want with the bucket tool to our completely erased and transparent layer. The Add New Layer command on the Layer tab, indicated by the plus symbol, adds a new transparent layer above or one line above the selected layer. The added layer is rendered in the current canvas aspect ratio, and we can change the layer order at any time. We scribble something else with the watercolor brush, but this time on the newly created second transparent layer on top instead of the white-coated layer on the bottom. As you can see, we made a mistake while typing or we want to make a change. Deletion, modification and visual manipulation on the new transparent layer can be managed in a more practical and easy way, independently of the images on the layer behind it or on the layers below it. This way, when the eraser tool is used on the top layer, the lower layers are not affected or distorted. Because the lower layers are secure, it is easier to make more open-ended image manipulations, changes and edits in a comfortable and secure way. In the upper right corner of each layer, there is an option indicated by the eye symbol that allows us to make the layer visible or invisible at any time, which is a very important convenience and an indispensable feature for layer management. We move the bottom layer to the top layer, and since this layer is a closed layer with a white background, All layers below it are naturally invisible. If the topmost layer is a closed layer, it hides all layers below it. In this case, you have three options to make the layer below visible again. First, move the topmost closed layer to the bottom layer or a lower layer. Second, turn off the visibility setting of the closed layer. And third, erase the topmost closed layer partially or completely with the eraser tool or other tools. All operations we perform on layers are processed on the selected layer. Notice that we can make changes to the selected layer and write on it with the brush tool even if the layer visibility is turned off. When we enable visibility again, you will be able to see the changes we have made more clearly. The most important point to understand here is that even if layer visibility is turned off, we are making changes to the layer we have selected. If we do not pay attention to this, we may make mistakes or experience confusion. The selected layer is displayed with a blue frame in the layer tab, so we can better see and manage which layer we are making changes to. Remember to check your selected layer when working with layers. With the undo keys, we undo the action and move the background layer back to the bottom row. To change the background color of our top transparent layer, we use the bucket tool to cover it with a color close to yellow. Notice that the bucket tool stopped when it reached the text borders and did not cover the areas inside the text. These areas are still transparent and have not completely changed the background color. Actually, there is a smoother and more effective way to change the background color. If we were to assign it to the background color on the bottom layer, we could do this without distorting the edge pixels in the text and without leaving the enclosed areas inside them empty or transparent. The result would look smoother and more professional. Now we change the background color with this method. First, we go back a few steps. As you can see, thanks to the bottom layer, we have easily changed the background color in a smoother, more practical, and professional way. We can also safely use any color we want without disturbing the pixels of the top layer. When we right-click on the current layer or on a layer we are hovering over, we can see the settings and commands related to the layer in the command tab that opens. This tab contains commands to adjust the visibility of the layer, duplicate the layer by copying it, merge the layer with a layer below it, move the layer up or down, and delete or remove the layer completely. We can also move the layer to the desired order by drag and drop. Here are a series of quick examples of everything we are talking about. Now we duplicate the transparent layer with the text we wrote with the brush at the top. Select the topmost of the duplicated layers and use the selection tool to move the text on it to the area below. As you can see, the two separate texts are now easily visible because they are no longer on top of each other. Note that we can reorder the layers at any time. It all depends on your preferences and the needs of the design you are creating. As we mentioned earlier, working with layers makes it incredibly easy to rearrange and manipulate parts of an image. As an example, with the brush at the bottom, we are rearranging and manipulating the text we have written to turn it into a better version, so that you can examine the initial version on the previous layer and the newly edited version on the new layer. More clearly distinguishable and easier to understand. This is just one of the many ways to use and benefit from layers. Previously, we delete the first unedited version and leave the more organized version, which we duplicate, modify, and edit. Now we save a single transparent layer of the edited version in PNG format, first as transparent. Notice that when you save the image file as PNG or any other format, the layers that appear in the image file are flattened and we can no longer edit the layers of that saved image file separately. So it is useful to save each layer separately in Paint, especially to be able to reuse the relevant layers when repeating the same work. We saved only the layer with the brush text with a transparent background and in PNG format. To save individual layers, simply turn off the visibility of other layers. In the same way, we leave the layer with the background color alone and save it separately. To do this, we either make the other layers invisible or, as in this case, delete them completely and save them. Now we open and examine each layer we have saved on the desktop, close and reopen the Paint program and start a new project. We will explain and reinforce the topic with more understandable and simpler examples about layers. We can open previous works in Paint again as a single layer with drag and drop method. But we can also create similar works by including new layers with import. We have given examples of this in our previous tutorials. We added a new layer, added the transparent layer on top of it with the insert command and created the same project as before, but in an alternative way. Of course, let's not forget that layers are merged during the recording phase, so let's re-emphasize the importance of saving and storing backup layers individually. We will now make the details of layers more understandable with simpler formal examples. To create a circle shape filled with red, select the circle from the ready-made shape tools and save it as a transparent layer in PNG format on the desktop. We create a new empty layer and use the ready-made shape tools to create a square shape filled with turquoise color. In the same way, we leave the turquoise square shape alone in the visible layers and save it alone as a transparent PNG on the desktop. To make the tutorial easier to understand, we add naming texts representing the layers. The layer at the bottom that provides the background color is called L1, background image. The next red circle is called L2. And the turquoise square is called L3, representing layer 3. On the same principle, we also create a green triangle shape, which we call L4, representing layer 4. By the way, if you pay attention, you can easily see that the top layer or layers overlap with their non-transparent parts and cover the layers below. This is one of the most important parts of the layers issue. Leaving only the fourth layer, L4, with the green triangle, we save it as a PNG on the desktop and then make all the layers visible and save it as another PNG on the desktop. We close the program and let's analyze the layers, or rather image files, that we have saved on the desktop up to this point. We open the Paint program again and drag and drop the image file containing all the shapes. As you can see, the image is opened, but it is no longer accessible or editable because the layers have been flattened, but now they have been flattened and merged into a single layer. Each image file we open opens as a single layer, but it is possible to open multiple layers and then import image files into them with the insert command. We remove the shapes from the image file containing multiple shapes, edit it so that only the text and background color remain, and save it to the desktop as a PNG and a separate version. We create new layers, import previously created saved image files into them with the insert command, and quickly perform a series of operations that show in a simple way what we can do with layers by changing and editing their order, position, and many other properties. You can easily notice that every change we make in the order of the layers is instantly updated on the canvas, and you can easily recognize which one is on top and which one is on the bottom. We create different combinations, like combining shapes and putting them together. We duplicated some layers and combined them with the layers below them to get new combinations. And we even resized these new combinations, edited them and saved them as PNGs on the desktop so that they could be seen on their own. You can set the layers you want to be visible or invisible. In other words, you can choose to display or not display what is inside them in the workspace or on the canvas. You can think of each layer as a separate page, and these pages can be stacked or overlapped to form a whole. Layers are thought of as pages stacked on top of each other. The bottom layer is the first page and the top layer is the last page. In overlapping layers, non-transparent parts overlap and cover other layers in the workspace. In the app, you can drag and drop layers to change their position and order. You can also right-click on any layer to see how to reorder the selected layer and other commands and features. So far, we have demonstrated many features both by repeating and practicing them. In this tutorial, we have provided a detailed step-by-step overview of the layer system in the new version of Paint and its basic usage practices. In future tutorials, we will cover the new features of Paint in more detail and even try to explain in full detail the use and application of all the tools. Of course, we'll learn how to do more complex things with layers using revolutionary new features, the advantages of background removal, and even dive deeper into creating AI-powered images. Let's keep exploring the new version of Paint together and unleash our creativity. We will continue the series with more beautiful trainings, and we will be with you again very soon.
Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.